Hey everyone, Deathblade here, also known as Jeremy. I'm doing a little bit of a different kind of video than usual. It's not a Chinese fantasy novel FAQ, which the majority of the videos on my channel are that. That said, it does relate to the novels, and I think it will pose food for thought for people who like Chinese fantasy novels and also science fiction novels and movies and animation and comics and all that stuff. But it also relates to just Chinese culture in general. Maybe I'll make more videos like this, I don't know. Let me know your reaction in the comments below, whether you like this kind of stuff, and maybe I'll think of a few more topics to explore. I'm really talking about examining how Chinese people think, or at least exploring the differences between the way Chinese people think and Westerners think. Of course, I know that Westerner or the West is a very nebulous and large concept, but the fact remains that Chinese people really do think differently. If you hear someone tell you that everyone in the world is the same, we're all just people, then that person is either very naive and ignorant, or they are lying to you, possibly because they have some sort of agenda. I was in the former camp, ignorant and naive. Growing up and leading up to my move to China, I really just did think that all people are just people. We're all the same underneath. Thing is, that is just not true. And if you are a person who has had a prolonged contact, deep contact with people from different cultures, you might have experienced that yourself. Now, I'm not saying one is better than the other or one is bad and one is good. I'm just saying that Chinese people think differently. It is something that I have come to learn in my time living in China. And of course, I am now a member of a Chinese family. My wife is Chinese. My in-laws, my relatives, basically none of them speak English. So I would say they are very authentic in terms of being Chinese. I think that there's a problem that comes with Westerners, non-Chinese people, who try to explain China and Chinese culture. Now, yes, I get the irony of that since that's literally exactly what I'm doing. But what I'm trying to say is that what I have experienced is that many people who pose as experts of Chinese culture, history, and language, and all that different stuff, a lot of them are very disconnected with what it actually means to be a part of Chinese culture. I don't want to go on and on about this aspect, but suffice it to say, there are many people, China experts, China watchers, Chinese, you know, historians or professors at colleges or people who have studied at college who are not part of Chinese culture. They just are not. I'm sorry to say that studying a bunch about something does not necessarily make you a true expert in that regard. Living in China for a couple years, to me, does not mean much. I think you need to be there for more than just a year or two to truly kind of immerse yourself in it. I think that people who have traveled a lot in China, that's meaningless. You can travel anywhere, multiple times even, and not really understand what life is like for those people. And even people who live in the big cities, sadly, I really see a disconnect from many of those people in terms of their understanding of the culture. Because living in one of those tier one cities like Beijing or Shanghai, life is very different there than it is in cities outside of those major metropolitan, cosmopolitan cities. I digress. Let's get to the subject at hand, which if you saw the title of the video or see the image that I'm putting up along with the video, you will know that I'm going to be talking about Confucius and Jesus. And specifically, I'm going to be contrasting two things they said. Something Jesus said, something Confucius said. For years, I have seen these things talked about, these two sayings talked about. And I've even seen some people claim that, well, let's just get into it and then I'll give my analysis. So the first is from Jesus, from the Bible. I'm sure most people that are listening to my channel have probably heard the golden rule before. Obviously, it can be stated in different ways, but the classic version is do unto others as you would have them do unto you. In other words, treat others the way you want to be treated. Confucius said something that is very similar. If you just do a Google search for Confucius quote, I just did it just now, and it's literally the first thing that pops up on the screen. And again, I have heard this quote discussed and analyzed in a variety of contexts. Basically, Confucius said, never do to others what you would not like them to do to you. Now, on the surface, those two statements do seem quite similar. I have seen, or I should say, heard people say, wow, isn't this amazing? Confucius actually came up with this idea way before Jesus did. You know, it was like 1,000 years or something. I forget exactly how long before Confucius lived. That said, these two statements are not the same. In fact, they're very, very different. So different that I would postulate that they're almost opposite. Jesus was essentially saying that you need to be proactive in doing good things. Treat people well. Treat them the way that you want to be treated. He was talking about doing things. Confucius's statement was very different, or is very different. He was talking about refraining from taking action, not doing something. And the goal was to prevent, you know, bad things from happening to you. So those are two different things. I'm not saying that one is better than the other. I'm not saying one is good or bad. I am just pointing out that they're very different. And the way of thinking that these two concepts can lead to, I think they're also very different. Now, I do want to point out a couple things. One, I am not a philosopher. Don't claim to be, don't have an interest in being one. Nor do I claim to be an expert on philosophy. I am not a person who studied, you know, fancy things in university. I mean, I did go to university and have a degree, but it's in art, okay, not philosophy or something. I don't claim to have studied philosophy and be an expert or anything like that. I'm just a guy who has lived life, experienced things, observed things, and thought about things. And so that's the perspective I am coming to this from, not the perspective of a person with a degree or, you know, who sits around philosophizing about things. Furthermore, I also know that you cannot boil down the teachings of Confucius into a single statement, nor can you boil down the teachings of Jesus into a single statement, because they said a lot of things, and all of the things that they said can be analyzed and whatnot. So I'm not trying to claim that these two statements from Confucius and Jesus are the pure and ultimate expression of their teachings. Suffice it to say, these two statements are very different, and I think they reveal a lot about the Western and Chinese way of thinking. Now, I want to talk about news articles or news stories. Imagine you're watching local news and you hear a story about someone drove their car off the side of the road or something. I just saw one of these the other day, in fact. Here in San Diego, where I live, a woman actually drove off a bridge and crashed down below. And the story was about how drivers pull off to the side and went down to help her. This kind of thing I don't think is necessarily happening all the time, but it's pretty common. You see somebody in trouble, people go and try to help them. News stories in China tend to be very different. The fact is that what's more common in China is that somebody will get hurt. They'll be on the street. Maybe they get hit by a car. Maybe there's a car accident. People don't help. They stand around and watch. It has happened over and over and over again to the point where in some locations in China, they have either talked about or have implemented rules to try to incentivize people to help. Ironically, these kind of rules, at least in the Western media, are called Good Samaritan rules, going back to Jesus. And for better or worse, that's just the way it is. That is what happens in China. Now, I'm not saying that that happens in China because Confucius said this. Again, Confucius said a lot of things, and throughout the history of China, there were many, many different philosophers, many different schools of thought. It's often said that the three primary belief systems throughout Chinese history have been Confucianism, Buddhism, and Taoism, but there are many others. So I'm not saying that all Chinese people think this one way because Confucius said this one thing. However, I do think it is indicative of a Chinese way of thinking that has been developing for thousands of years. When you read the novels or when you watch TV shows, movies, animations, or whatever it is, you will see the characters acting in certain ways. That is a portrayal or at least a reflection of Chinese way of thinking. I'm mostly talking about web novels here and the web novel authors who are mainland Chinese people, but I do think it is very interesting. I have thought about this topic for a long time, and I have talked about it with Chinese friends, talked about it with my wife, and I have come up with various theories about how Chinese people think. And this is just one little aspect, one little thing I've noticed. And I was doing some digging into Chinese philosophy recently and noticed this connection between Jesus and Confucius and thought it was really interesting and wanted to bring it to your attention. So what do you think about this topic in general and this little kind of unique, interesting connection regarding the golden rule and Confucius's saying? Do you think it's indicative of some sort of pattern of thinking? Do you think it means nothing? I look forward to your comments below. And if you're interested in this kind of stuff, please let me know. I do have other thoughts and observations on this subject, and it might be interesting to kind of delve into it a little bit more, a little bit deeper, and look more closely at Chinese philosophy and religion and how it relates to the novels and the culture and all of that stuff. If you like my content in general, please do like and subscribe and share and all those things. You can check out the links in the description below for ways to support the channel. That's it for this video. I will see you next time.